Was heard me and Pharaoh was about to drop this false teaching, part two. These niggas got erratic than a motherfucker. Niggas went to slandering, foaming at the goddamn mouth line. These niggas supposed to be the children of God. They talking about peace. They talking about equality, freedom, and all the lying ass other shit that they claim they practice, but they are some low slanderous ass niggas. See, we got to call people on the shit that they say they believe in. And when you go off into the Moor Science Temple, they talking about love, harmony, equality, freedom, and all this other shit. But when you see the niggas all since me and Pharaoh, and we coming with scholarship, and you should be able to present scholarship for scholarship. But you niggas have presented nothing but slander, and so that show us your true goddamn nature. You see, the door must be open. You see, the information can no longer be contained. See, this is the thing, we cannot unify, okay, under the term, you know, of any type of ideology until the house is first cleared, until first the house is cleaned out, okay? And a lot of people say, oh, well, Pharaoh and Seti, all they doing is attacking niggas. If I'm attacking the white man, niggas, I'm attacking the white man. That's what the fuck we got to deal with. If the nigga is the one, if the white man then taught the nigga to whip his own brother's back, you can watch the movie Sankofa, where that nigga was whipping his own brother, his own sister back. Who do you go to first? When it's time to get liberation, who do you go? You don't run to the cracker, you run to the nigga first who whipping your back. And so these is the niggas who have been trained to whip their own brothers and sisters back with lies and treasonous information that they know that's going to keep the people enslaved, keep the people on the plantation. That's exactly what happened. See, when you talking about the Moor Science Temple, the Nation of Islam, they co-opted many terminologies from Marcus Garvey's UNIA, one of those key terms was nationality, because they knew that the people wanted to be free. And Marcus Garvey said, God damn it, we got to get away from the white man. These niggas is crying on their fucking knees, sucking the white man off, got the white man cum dripping all down his goddamn jaw. Nation of Islam want the cracker to give him half of the land. These niggas telling you to go downtown and fill out a fake ass application. These niggas is tying you back to the goddamn plantation. And y'all niggas cannot see, but they tricked you because they knew that the people wanted nationality. So they fed off of that, but then they diverted and they threw a misdirection in. And instead of you going to Africa and establishing your own land, nigga, you still here in America with no option whatsoever. They still killing your ass in the street. Still jumping on your babies, still jumping on your women, killing the brothers for wholesale, even right now today, even though Marcus Garvey told you niggas that that was going to continue to happen to you until you get up off of your goddamn ass and get your own. So these niggas have done our people a disservice, because Marcus Garvey had ships. Marcus Garvey was trying to take us back home over 100 years ago. And if they had not sabotaged the great Messiah, ain't no telling where we would be at this time. So for these niggas to have diverted from the teachings of Marcus Garvey in over 100 years, the goddamn Moor Science Temple was over 100 years old, the goddamn Nation of Islam is 88 years old, and they have not done no more for the people. You ought to take every last one of them niggas out and onto a tree, just like these goddamn crackers, and put these niggas' neck in a motherfucking noose and hang they ass. Because they have no doubt betrayed our people to the United States of America and the colonial powers. As Pharaoh showed down many times through the ages, how these niggas with the fezzes was nothing but the soldiers for the goddamn colonial power. This truth has been crying out, trying to get out for years. And so you can see that today the door will be open. The ancestors is trying to get out so that the truth can be known to the people today. The Moore Science Temple is a pseudo-Islamic organization. It's pseudo. I said pseudo. That too. They all that. They all fucked up. Pseudo-Islamic organization. You understand what I'm saying? Once you know the tenets of Islam, you know these niggas is not Muslims. And I'm not portraying Islam to be the rightful religion of our people. But what I am, I know the tenets of that false religion. And that Islam of Arabia is the first Islam. Okay? That was the first Islam. So now what they do is they kidnap words from other religions. They kidnap words from other cultures and they pervert those words so that they don't mean the same thing as they originally meant. When you go into the Moore Science Temple, you and even the Aquarian Gospel of Jesus Christ, you will see that Jesus is not going to India. Jesus in Europe, that wasn't in the original book. It wasn't in the original lie. So they've taken Jesus, they've taken Buddha, they've taken Muhammad, and they've co-opted those characters and rewrote the narrative, okay, to fool you that this is actually Islam. One of the first tenet of Islam is your Shahada. You must accept Allah as your God and Muhammad of Arabia as the prophet of Allah. And in Orthodox Islam, the prophethood is sealed. There is no more prophets after the prophet of Muhammad of Arabia. So for Noble Drew Ali to call himself a goddamn prophet within Islam is blasphemous. And they know that. And if you was to take that book to Mecca, the Circle 7 Quran, and say, and show them Arabs over there a picture of Noble Drew Ali and say that he's a prophet of Islam, them niggas gonna come back in two boxes, one for his goddamn body and one for his goddamn head. They gonna chop your motherfucking head off. The Nation of Islam is a pseudo-Islamic organization because they practice some of the same tenets, false tenets, different tenets, because each group, when you're dealing with theosophy, you're going to notice the Mormons is a theosophic society where they kidnap Jesus and rewrite the narrative of who he is. And so you got this strange, even stranger story of Jesus Christ. You understand what I'm saying? He brother with Lucifer and all of this shit. And they having all these babies in heaven and shit. You can have 1,000 babies in heaven. You a God and everybody is a God and all of this shit. So this is another theosophic society who follow the tenets of Madame Blavatsky. The Jehovah Witness is another fraternal theosophic society. They kidnap the teachings of Jesus and so on and rewrote a narrative. This is what they do. And they all have prophets within that religion. If you go into the Mormons, the head of Mormonism is a prophet. So you can see that when Madame Blavatsky brought that type of teaching, you'll see prophets all over the goddamn United Snakes of America. You have prophet Father Divine. It is all these fathers and there's all these prophets. These is different characteristics of theosophy, okay? Which again is all of the esoterical institutions of the world combined, whether it's Sufism, whether it's Kabbalism, whether it's Luciferianism, whether it's Hinduism, whether it's Buddhism, they combine all of them together. And so you don't know whether you're coming or going when you're dealing with these groups. Neither organization practices the strict tenets of Orthodox Islam that identifies one as a true Muslim. These niggas say, I mean, you got the Circle 7 Quran saying that it's the Quran of the holy city of Mecca, which is untrue. You take that book to Mecca and tell them that this is their holy book. And again, them niggas will get their head cut off. Both organizations co-opted lingo of the Islamic faith to give you the illusion that they are two, that they are Muslims, or at the least practicing some form of Islam, and they are not. Okay? They are not. So when you see these niggas put Islam on their identity card, identification card, sovereignty card, nigga, that is to fool you that you are becoming something, but in actuality, they tricking you niggas onto the boat. They just like they tricked you the last time. They tricking you onto the boat. This is what they did in Africa. Trick niggas onto the boat, okay? Because these were the Negroes that had access to the interior of Africa. Come on, we got a job for you, nigga. Man, these crackers taking us over here, nigga, they're going to give you so much gold. They're going to give you all this and that. And when you got on the goddamn boat, the cracker put chains on your neck, on your motherfucking wrist, and on your ankles. So we are fighting occult wars, and what you do not know can and will destroy you if one of a righteous heart does not reveal the truth unto you. And so that's what we're doing here today. You got to get back to your Garveyism. You got to get back to your John Henry Clark, Khalid Muhammad, Dr. Ben-ism. Okay, you got to get back to your Francis Crest Wilson-ism. You got to get back to your Shaka Musa Barashango-ism. See, you got to get back to the master teachers and mistress teachers that put this down originally with a righteous heart. You know what I'm saying? So when I say black power, I'm not talking about none of you niggas, because you got to earn it more today than you ever had to earn it. Back then, we had so many great leaders that you knew had a righteous heart. So these niggas is saying any and everything out of their mouth as a means of costume revolutionaries. See, these niggas is costume. They not real in their heart. They walk is not that of a real revolutionary. So today, when I say black power, and you hear another nigga say black power, we ain't talking about the same goddamn black power. Nigga, I'm out here really liberating the minds of my people, exposing you fake ass niggas. Okay, and so there cannot be no unity in the conscious community any goddamn way. Because when I went on the goddamn internet, you can see where the Nation of Islam and the Moor Science Temple do not identify as the same type of Islamic organization. Nigga, they got combative fucking rhetoric between each group, which will not cause them to unify. So if two supposed Islamic groups cannot unify amongst each other, how the fuck is the black power community gonna unify with a group like the Nation of Islam and the Moor Science Temple, and when all of the Islamic groups, based on their rhetoric, cannot unify amongst themselves, and they claim to be Islamic? So you niggas, those out there that talking unity, you niggas is much a agent as them niggas. Because if you knew anything about what would cause us to unify and see that we don't have it, because there are too many groups all over the place with different ideology, and the only way we're going to unify if we have a common ideology. So to scream unity before we have that common ideology is a form of treason. You trying to trick us to attempt to put our energy in something that cannot be done. Okay? Occult Egypt is a sadistic, demonic lie created to confuse the world of the true origins of Egypt, ancient Africa, and Asia. So when you hear the Moor Science Temple teach about Egypt, when you hear the Nation of Islam teach about here Egypt, when you hear the Rosicrucians, which is another occult Freemasonry group that has plagiarized, perverted, and distorted ancient Egypt, this is an occult Egypt. And so what you niggas do is that y'all niggas, anytime y'all hear Egypt, you niggas dive in head first. You think every time you hear Egypt, it's the truth. Okay, 95% of what being taught out here about Egypt is a goddamn lie. That's why we had to come with the false teachings of the Medunetta to show you this. And it's what's so crazy that they won't even tell you how many theosophists and Freemasons was Egyptologists, okay? And that much of what the Egyptologists is teaching is from theosophy. They believe that ancient Egypt was founded by some fucking Atlanteans that came from Atlantis. Y'all don't even know this shit, okay? So when they teach that a white race, they just won't lead you back far enough so you can see the rest of the story. They'll just tell you some white people came in and founded Egypt, even though the European had not even produced a civilization on the continent of Europe yet. So if the white man came in and created Egypt, what white man was that? Because y'all had not even produced the first civilization yet, which was Greece. They talking about Atlantis. See, they talking about Atlantis. But they don't want to show you so much of their story because they know people going to say, wait a minute, I don't know nothing about no goddamn Atlantis. Our teachers told us that ancient Egypt came from the heart of Africa. It came out of Central East Africa, down by the Great Lakes region of Africa. And then it flowed down the Nile River, you know, from Ethiopia, Zimbabwe, Uganda, into Sudan, then into Egypt. Nobody taught me that some Atlantean started some goddamn Egypt. So when you hear these groups like the Moorish Science Temple and Nation of Islam teach about Egypt, they are teaching about the Egypt of the Theosophists who was started by Madame Blavatsky. You got other notorious Theosophists like Aleister Crowley, who was probably the second most popular Theosophist outside of Madame Blavatsky. Then you got Albert Pike and so on and so forth. This is where that occult Egypt comes from, okay? When you pull back the veil of deception and dissect the teachers of both organizations, you will see that these are Freemason, Theosophic, Luciferian occults in league with many other cults like Mormonism, Jehovah's Witness, Wiccan, Ku Klux Klan, because they're Freemason, but they are also a cult. They are also a cult. Albert Pike, who didn't find the Scottish Rite, but he rewrote the rules and regulations of the Scottish Rite, so he might as well have found that shit. Okay, he is considered the greatest Mason of all time. His book, Morals and Dogma, is the Bible of Scottish Rite. Scientology is another occult, theosophical, okay, Ron L. Hubbard. You see, and another thing that you're going to see is the alien effect, okay? You're going to see that Madame Blavatsky talked much about that, about the alien effect, okay? That the aliens came down and gave the Atlanteans and gave the Lumerians some advanced technology, okay? She the one brought that. So when you talk about Hitler, who was a follower of Madame Blavatsky, that's where he got his Aryan philosophy from, because she was a racist and taught that the Aryans was the most powerful race on the planet. Okay, and that include Caucasians. It include the Hindu of India, who put down another caste system on the Africans over there in Asia. Okay, that's where that caste system comes from, because they practicing Aryanism that was founded by Madame Blavatsky. She's clearly the key racist. Goddamn Charles Darwin took from that bitch. Even Mahatma Gandhi, who was a fucking Hindu over in India, he was a member of the Theosophic Society founded by Madame. So I don't want y'all to lessen this bitch, her strength, and the level of her teachings. She taught some of the most wicked and some of the greatest minds that's on the planet, okay? And her headquarters was in India, and so she was on, that's where you get this fucking noble Jew. I ain't even got into the pictures yet. I got to warm you up so that once these pictures kick in, this shit gonna get real to you real fucking soon. The gypsies, okay? The gypsy, you go get your number book. You see the Hindu head wraps on your goddamn number books. You're under the three wise men, the circle seven number book. I remember that book back shit when I was a kid, when my mama and grandmamas and them was playing the numbers and they had street numbers. And everybody had a fucking dream book and a number book where they had the circle seven dream book way back then. So that circle seven is an occult number and has always been an occult number. Okay. Rosicrucians and Freemasonry also is theosophical occult groups. Okay. Let me go in. Now, when you look at this occultism, I got this damn, this is a vintage, quilt. And so you see on this vintage quilt, shit, it got 50 different goddamn textiles on this one goddamn quilt. It got, well, you know, it got over 50 different textiles on this goddamn forms of cloth on the goddamn quilt, taken from different cloths. So that's what occultism is. It's not no one thing. They're taken from so many and they're weaving it together. It's Arianism, it's Hindu Sufism, Hindu Islam, Buddhism, Christianity. You got teachings coming out of Tibet. You got the Ahmadiyya Muslims. You got the Turkish Islam. You got Atlantis, you got Lumeria teachers. Okay, so it's a accumulation of all type of esoterical teachings on the planet. We got these dates here in case we have to, you know, make it clear on who came first and who took from who. You see, the Shriners, well, the white Shriners were founded in 1870. Just like Pharaoh was saying, they're gonna say, oh, that the niggas, that the white man took it from them. That's a goddamn lie. The first group in America of black people that was wearing the fez in mass was the Prince Hall Shriner. And they were founded in 1893. That's 23 years after the white Shriners. So the white Shriners was wearing the fez first in numbers, okay? In numbers. You got the Theosophical Society founded in 1875. That's Madame Blavatsky and William Steele Olcott, the two founders of the Theosophical Society. They founded it in New York, and then they moved it to India in 1886. We're going to see the Ahmadiyya Islam movement was founded in 1889. They come out of Pakistan. And the reason why we got to bring them up is because they was the ones that created Jesus being in India, which is an occult teaching. You find that all throughout occult. Well, they was the ones that founded that. And so you're going to see, and not only that, Fraud Muhammad suggested to the Nation of Islam, if that they're going to read the Quran, that they read two Qurans, the Yusuf Ali Quran and the Maulana Muhammad Ali Quran, both coming out of Pakistan. And Maulana Muhammad Ali was from the Ahmadiyya Muslims, which are not Orthodox Muslims. They have some esoterical teachings in their Islam, and they are suppressed in Orthodox Islam. They kill their ass because they teacher, which I'm gonna show you, also claimed to be a prophet, that he was the returning Messiah of Jesus Christ, because Islam still believes that Jesus Christ is coming back. So the founder of the Ahmadiyya Muslims, which I'm gonna show you, said that he was the coming Christ. And because in Orthodox Islam, they believe that Muhammad was the last prophet, they suppress and kill these Ahmadiyya Muslims. Wherever there's dominant Shiite and Sunni groups, they kill their ass for their teachers. So why would the Nation of Islam give y'all some old esoterical ass Quran that they know that the founder and his group is being suppressed all throughout Orthodox Islam. So they set y'all niggas up right there. But what I'm saying is, you're going to see that the theosophists were already teaching about Jesus in India before Farad Muhammad suggested that the Nation of Islam study the fucking Quran of the Ahmadiyya Muslims. The white boys had already came in contact with the Ahmadiyya Islam before Farad Muhammad, before the Nation of Islam, before the Moorish Science Temple. Blavatsky and her group was already over there co-opting all of that information. So I seen a video from Paul Guthrie, who was a scholar who was trying to say that Farad Muhammad was a Buddhist, that he was from India, and that what he was teaching was Buddhism. Paul Guthrie sold the goddamn community short. That man ain't no goddamn Buddhist. That man is a fucking Freemason. He got that shit from them theosophists. If he just sell you short and tell you that this nigga didn't dress like no damn Buddhist. Buddhist bald head with some goddamn little barely got clothes on their goddamn back. This motherfucker had on a suit. Motherfucker had a fade, had a taper. You know, goddamn Buddhist got no taper and no goddamn suit like that. That motherfucker was a Freemason. And I can show you that. And what's clear about why Paul Guthrie is very dangerous, because we just show and taught what is the objective of the Freemasonry. What's the objective of pan-Islamism? What is the objective of the Moorish Science Temple? What is the objective? And so if he come and tell you that this shit is just Buddhism and then don't teach you what these covert groups is doing to you, he leaving you out in the fucking open to be shot down by the motherfucking groups that's trying to do this to you. So that nigga, what he taught is not the truth. And anytime Paul Guthrie want to get with me, he can get with me. And I'll show you all the flaws in your teachings. The Prince Hall Shriners founded in 1893. Moorish Science Temple founded in 1913. So it show you that the Prince Hall Shriners was wearing the fez 20 years before the Moorish Science Temple was founded. And I can come back to these. I will come back to these when it's necessary to come back to them. Let me go on off into this. Now I'm gonna say, when I say theosophy, I'm gonna just say Blavatskyism. So you know exactly what I'm talking about. If I say theosophy, you're gonna have to study this for a minute so you can really grasp what it is. Occult racism and witchcraft. And I want y'all to know, if Madame Blavatsky was born in America around the 1600s, that bitch would have been burnt at the stake. Okay, so she was a witch. I'm not gonna downplay what she was. Fucking Aleister Crowley was a fucking witch, is exactly what he was. He even claimed himself to be the most wicked man that ever lived. He calls himself the Beast 666. Okay, so these is his own words coming out his mouth telling you who he is. And if this man is the Beast and he's 666 and he's the wickedest man in the world and he trained Ron L. Hubbard and the Moorish Science Temple partners with Scientology and the group of Ron L. Hubbard, what the fuck is Farrakhan? Nigga, ain't no getting up out of that. Nigga, you sold our people to this motherfucking beast is what you did. I want you to stay, these is key terms, the seven root races. You see that seven? That seven is very popular in a cult. Madame Blavatsky brought the seven root races. Okay, talking about, you know, there was ages of different races on the planet. And the great race of today is the Aryan race. Okay, the Aryan race, the Hindu, the Caucasian, even the goddamn Mongolians and all of this. See, they fucking brought all these groups together where they stole the occult knowledge and made one great race called the Aryan race. Okay, niggas ain't in that race. Okay, we are considered the downtrodden. Okay, when you talk about us, that's why in fucking Hinduism, the blacks ain't even in the damn caste system. Nigga, we outside of the caste system. That's why they call us outcasts. So we ain't even in the damn caste system. So this is the teachings of the racist white witch, Madame Blavatsky, who was the mother of damn near all Freemason teachings, all goddamn occult teachings in the Western fucking world. That includes Europe too. Okay, I want you to, the Great White Brotherhood, she brought that. Serapis Bay, that Pharaoh brought up, which I'm gonna espouse on it even greater. She was the first one to say she talked to Serapis Bay. So you're gonna see in theosophy, they do what they call channeling, where some spirit comes into your body and talks through you. That's channeling. So she say Serapis Bay came into her and channeled through her and gave her the information to write her book, Secret Doctrine, which the white boys went through her book and found out she plagiarized just like fucking Noble Drew Ali. So that was one. See, they was going over into Asia and into Africa stealing literature, but and they didn't believe that we would ever get over there and see where they got it from. So they rewrote all the information to make it look like they was the authors of it. But when the information age and then people started to go to these places and do their own research, they found out that these motherfuckers have been stealing all kind of shit, rewriting it and fucking putting their names on it. So she was busted by her own white scholars for plagiarizing both of her great works, Secret Doctrine and Isis Unveiled. El Moria. Okay, El Moria. Now I want you to look at that more. I want you to look at that El. I want y'all to look at that bait. El Moria is another ascended master, a great spirit, a great individual who through, you know, great illumination rose up into the ethers and still wanted to help humanity. So they choose somebody on earth who calls themselves a prophet. That's why each one of these motherfuckers who say they talking to one of these great spirits, which they call ascended masters, call themselves a prophet. You can go on, the Mormonism, the Jehovah Witness, all of them motherfuckers do the same thing. That shit come from Madame Blavatsky. So you're going to see that she was already discussing Serapis Bay and El Moria in 1875. I'm going to go right back to the date. See? Theosophy Society, 1875. So when you talk about the Moor, when they say Moor and they say El and they say Bay, they're not talking about, let me go back. They're not talking about the historical Moor in your goddamn history book. See? Now we getting down to the real shit. That's why they say, but they blended it all in because they know people started to do research. So then they had to claim it all. But in claiming it all, they had so many fucking contradictions with they dumb ass. See, your man's Noble Drew Ali fucked you up because he never foresaw that there would be an information age where all of that information will clearly be accessible to anyone who looked for it. You can no longer lie, and you niggas just became Moors in jail, nigga. Shut the fuck up. You ain't read nothing but the Circle 7 Quran, nigga. That's all you ever read. You don't have the proper fucking scholarship, nigga, to even debate the information because the information is right and exact. Okay? So we're going to be, I want y'all to stay. These key words, Bay, El, Moor, Moo. That's why they spell Moor sometimes, M-U-U-R. Okay, Lumeria, or the land of Mu, and the theosophists, white Europeans created all of this shit. So the question becomes to me, if you an ancient Moor The question becomes, where is your literature? Why the fuck is you keep plagiarizing from white people who just really created these old fake ideas in the late 1800s, so on and so forth? You supposed to have your own literature. You should not be plagiarizing from Europeans. And you claim to be the sovereign man. You claim to be the God. You claim to be the highest of creation. And here you is plagiarizing from people who actually look at you as lower than low. In them damn teachings, you are outcast. You are a maximum, which they call, you know, Africa and North America. Obviously, they saying that both of these land masses was combined. And it's called a maximum, which you can see, obviously see Mexico in the middle of that. These niggas believe that North America was populated before Africa. Do you understand that? See, y'all niggas ain't got off into that. When you get off into the root races, they teach that North America was populated before Africa. Lumeria was in the Pacific Ocean, and they claim and they came from Lumeria. And when Lumeria was destroyed, many of the survivors went to the landmass of North America and Atlantis. And from Atlantis, the Aryan race, which was the last route, when Atlantis went up under the water, then the Aryan race became the most powerful race on the planet. And so they was the ones that founded Egypt. So the way they teach it, Asia, it went from Asia to North America, then to Africa. Africa was the last goddamn continent to be populated. This is why these niggas talking about they was over here first. See, we getting down today, baby. The Koran, K-O-R-A-N, which is a European term. Anybody that uses Koran is usually of European descent. So the fact that, and Muslim too, and I'm gonna show you that. So the fact that these niggas call their shit the Holy Koran is obvious to see that they don't know no Arabic. They don't know no Arabic. How the fuck is you a Muslim? How the fuck you from the holy city of Mecca? How you fuck you from, and you don't know no Arabic. The only four fucking words that both the Nation of Islam and the Moore Science Temple know is Islam, Mecca, Allah, and Mohammed. And they might say, and the motherfucking Moors don't even say Assalamu alaikum. They say Islam and tell you it means something different other than what the Arab who created it defined it as. They tell you it means something else. Okay? That's perversion. That's co-opted. Okay? The white brotherhood, which is all of the ascended masters together. What elements make up Freemasonry? Luciferianism, Arianism, Blavatskyism. Okay, here the witches. We're getting into the pictures now. Here we go. This is the white witch, Madame Blavatsky, 32nd degree Mason, Luciferian witch. Okay? This is the first person that ever spoke to Serapis Bey, which is the deity of the Moorish Science Temple. That's why they call themselves Bey. No different than a person who follows Jesus Christ called himself a Christian. They also follow another ascended master, El Moria. That's why they call themselves Moors. Not because they the historical Moor, because they fucking deity, one of their deities, is El Moria. And they believe they come from Lumeria. They also, and then you got another crazy cracker. You got two different continents. You got Mu and Lumeria. You got one say Lumeria was in the Indian Ocean. Then you got one that say these is all sunken goddamn continents. Ain't this some crazy shit? So that's why we ain't got no place on the planet, because where we supposed to come from, then sunk under the goddamn water. Okay? It then sunk up under the goddamn water. Okay? Here we go. And so the other cracker on the end is William Steele Olcott, who with Madame Blavatsky formed the Theosophic Society. And you see right here that they co-opt the obelisk, they co-opt the ankh, they co-opt many symbols from ancient Egypt into their Luciferian occult. And you're going to see that the head of this Luciferian occult is the Pope. The Vatican Church is at the head. And then you're going to see that the top Masonic group is the Jesuits, who run all of that shit, who run for the Vatican City, the Knights of Malta. They report to the damn Jesuit. With the head of the Jesuits is the Black Pope. You will see him. Just look him up. The Black Pope. Okay. And so the Jesuits was formed to protect the Catholic Church. When the Protestants came on the scene and tried to go against the Catholic Church, the Jesuits was formed. And they are the most subversive group on the planet. The CIA ain't got shit on the Jesuit. A Jesuit will become any member of any organization on the planet to destroy that shit. A Jesuit will give his whole life to a fucking being a mole in an organization just to take control of it. This is how deep these Jesuits is. When you're talking about Westhoff, who started the Illuminati, he was a Jesuit. Adam Westhoff was a Jesuit. Okay, so they run Freemasonry. So when you see these niggas dressing up in a Freemasonry garb, using the Freemasonry handshakes, using the Freemasonry teaching, theosophic teachings, and this, that, and the third, you got to ask yourself, who is really at the head of the Nation of Islam? Who is really at the head of the Moorish Science Temple? Who is really at the head of the Prince Hall Shriners? Who is the head of the NAACP and all of these groups where Masons flood them goddamn organization? This is the Theosophy Society in India to show you that they went there and they co-opted the Hindu religion. They was already in contact with the Ahmadiyya Muslims long before any group in the United States of America. Okay, they got more than one. This is a different. I think this one is in northern India, one is in southern India, but they got headquarters all over the nation of India. And so you see Madame Blavatsky with her ugly ass standing up in between them two Hindus. You see William O. Cox sitting up under her, and you see all them damn gurus and this, that, and the third. This is where goddamn Noble Drew Ali got his information from. Okay, this is Besant, who took over the Theosophy Society after Annie Besant, who took over the Theosophy Society after Madame Blavatsky died. You see all of the Hindu head wraps. You see that these crackers actually reformed Hinduism and Buddhism and taught it back to the Hindus. No different than they took over Egypt and created Egyptology and sold it to niggas. And to the world. This is exactly what they did to all histories on the planet. So when you see Blavatsky sitting there with the Hindus, damn near, when you're talking about 1875, almost 50 years before the Moorish Science Temple was formed. This is where they got that information. They didn't go to India themselves. They got that information through theosophists who were trained by Madame Blavatsky. So you see these niggas look like, it look like Halloween. It look like Halloween. These niggas dressed up as all type of Hindus, got Turkish fezes on their head to show that they the property of the Turk, which is a gypsy, which is a Sufi, okay? And we got to understand that what type of Islam, because you got all types of Islam, okay? So when you talk about Turkish Islam, you talking about Sufi Islam. You're talking about really ain't even Islam. What is this saying when you're a Sufi? That means you don't read the Quran, nor are there any mosques. You just do your whatever practice you feel like. When you're talking to Allah, you do that. Okay, that's all. That's really what we say about spirituality. When you ain't got no books and you ain't got no temples and mosques. So when I looked at the history of the Ottoman Turks, when they first conquered the Byzantine Empire, they were Sufis. Even though they identified them as Muslims, They were Sufi. That means they were nomads. They did not have the knowledge of architecture. They was not worshiping in mosques. They was worshiping out in the open. They was doing all type of dancing and round the fire, partying, making all type of noises that the Orthodox Muslim consider heretic. So that's just when Walter Williams said that they did not have Islam into the Quran. They did not. The Ottoman Turks were not in no mosque, and they were not. They did not have no Quran. They were Sufis. Go do the research. So that's what it is. And so when you see that Fez came with them up out of their homeland. And the homeland that people don't even understand is not Turkey today. They migrated into Turkey. The homeland, the original homeland of the Turk is in Mongolia. Damn. Damn. Here we go. And so when you call them Sufis, that means wool. And so when you see, you go back over there to Turkey and Mongolia and India where it's cold, you're going to see that those fezes are made out of wool. Nigga, that's why they call them Sufis. So really, the fez ain't even got shit to do with Islam. It is a cultural trait of people who come up out of Mongolia, northern India. I can show you even from ancient time where they were already wearing that hat. Has nothing to do with Islam, even though it has been adopted later on by Islam. It was later adopted by Islam. And people who did not know the origins of it assumed that it was always a part of Islam, and it was not. It came with the Turk. You can see the Mongolians wearing the wool hats, and the Russians wearing the wool fezes. Anybody that came up out of that region wears that hat. So it's more of adopting you as property of the Turk. The Turk, more so than Islam, okay? So you see that most of what they got on is up out of that region. The Hindu, the Turk, nigga, you niggas is all, and then you say you aboriginal to the America, okay? Now, you can't be all over the goddamn place, motherfucker. You're going to have to pick a spot. You're going to have to, is you from Turkey? You from Mongolia? You from Arabia? Nigga, you from goddamn North Carolina? You from Mississippi? Where the fuck is you from? You claim the miles in Mississippi. You claim the city of Mecca. You claim you're from the land of Canaan. Then you niggas went and established the Moroccan Empire in Morocco. Then you niggas was in Lumeria. Then your niggas was in Atlanta. Nigga, where is the fuck is you from, nigga? That's where I want to know. You niggas is all over the board because your man, Noble Drew Ali, set your bitch ass up when he put that fake information together in the first goddamn place. So when you see Noble Drew Ali right there with that hat on, that's occultism, nigga. That ain't got nothing to do with no Islam. Motherfuckers looking off into a goddamn crystal ball telling you, nigga, that you need sovereignty and follow my way, nigga, and I'm going to lead you down the path of success, and I'm going to lead you to your freedom, this, that, and the third. And then you got these, follow the gypsies. Follow them. They was some of the early occultists in that region, and they come up out of India. I got that information. They migrated into Turkey. They migrated into Egypt. But I got the research that the gypsies come up out of India. Okay, the Turks come up out of Mongolia. So this is all of the peoples that got some form of practice that the Moore Science Temple stole from, that Madame Blavatsky stole from. Okay? Right there. Now, our people have our own occult practices. Okay, I'm not going to say that our people, because our people do. When you look at Voodoo and you look at all, what's the other forms? It's all other forms of like Voodoo, and it's another couple of, now that's our occult teachers. Okay, now if you're doing it through the African occultism, I can understand that. I can understand that. But if you using European methods to achieve what you doing, nigga, then use a European. I have to say that. I can't go hard on Christianity, go hard on God, European Christianity, and all of it is European. I can't go hard on Islam. I can't go hard on these other ones and not go hard on the white man, esoterical, fake-ass teachers. I got to go just as hard on that, too. And but many of what you dealing, now, if you're dealing with voodoo, you're dealing with the African, you're going the right way. But if you niggas out there, you got Aleister Crowley, who created a tarot deck. It's called the Thoth deck. He's the one that created that. Matter of fact, Aleister Crowley created the first Egyptian tarot deck in existence. He the one done that. Okay? Now, it's other people who might create one after his, but if you got that Thoth deck, T-H-O-T-H, deck, that's Aleister Crowley. Okay? That's Aleister Crowley. And that just show you how powerful that wicked motherfucker is, because people are using his shit and don't even know that they're using it. Okay? And if this man talking about he conjuring demons and he created this fucking deck and through the spirit of the devil talking through him, I advise you to take that motherfucker to the nearest goddamn barbecue grill and set that shit on fire. Because, nigga, you don't know what you conjuring when you using some of these sick motherfuckers' creations, okay? Reading tea leaves was a part of the gypsies, where they, you know, they'll boil tea, and then they, once the tea is out of the damn, they'll look inside of the tea and on the tea leaf, or they'll look at the stains that the tea leaves have left in the cup to tell you your future. You understand what I'm saying? That was one of the methods of the gypsies. Okay, so now when you see Noor Ali dressed up as a fucking gypsy, as a Hindu, you know where he got it from. He did not get it from here. Okay, because when you study the American Indian, they wasn't dressing like this. Okay, they wasn't dressing like this. They didn't have the same deities. They did not have the same deity. They had a whole different system. And then on top of that, the Indian in America is not the original man of this land. The oldest civilization in the Americas is the Olmec, based on proper history, okay? Using architecture, using writing, the Olmec, which are African people, okay? This is the oldest. So you can't even, you know, say that the Indian, what y'all call the Native American, that's a goddamn lie. He's not native to this land. He's not native to it. He's not the first man on this. And so I'm sick of motherfuckers trying to give him. He come out of Asia, but he got his own fucking culture, but he come out of Asia. He came through the Bering Straits. Our people came over here on ships, okay? And we landed in the Yucatan. We landed in the central Mexico, which is a part of the tropical region. We didn't go up north where it was cold. We landed where it was similar to where we came from, okay? And so even when you look at this sister right here, she got this hairdress on as a Hindu. She don't have it on even, and let's use the name, the so-called American Indian, if you want to. You ain't never seen no goddamn American Indian worship no Rama, okay? This is the hairdress of Lord Rama, which is a Hindu deity, okay? Look at this right here. You see the hairdress of these sisters? I mean to disrespect. I'm only using this as historical reference. I'm sorry, Noor Ali did not tell you where he got this shit from. Maybe you did know, and you still wanted to play the role, but you busted today. Okay, that's Hindu, has nothing to do with the so-called American Indian. So if you was Aboriginal to this land, I'm asking the question, why the fuck is you got on headdress, you got on garb of a man damn near 6,000 miles from where the fuck the land you say you Aboriginal to? And then you're talking about Canaan. You could go right now today, you don't see no goddamn so-called people from so-called Israel, the original people, which is the Egyptians. You say the Egyptians came from Canaan, but it's actually the goddamn reverse. that what you call Canaan, because there is no land of Canaan, never was no land of Canaan, because that's a biblical term, and that the Bible is a lie. So I see you caught up there. And then you say you was a Moabite. Okay, and then that means you believe in the Bible. Well, ain't no Native American got no goddamn Bible until the white man brought it over here to him. Okay, they didn't have no Bible. They worship nature. Okay, they did do that. They worship the sun. They worship the moon. They worship the animals, the zoo types, and so on and so forth. Venerated the zoo types. They did not worship no goddamn Bible. None of these continents and original people of any of these continents had the Bible until the white man showed up. Okay? So you say you the Moabite. That's biblical, nigga. And the Moabites were the children of Lot and his own daughters through incest. Okay? After the Sodom and Gomorrah was destroyed, the only people that survived the destruction of Sodom and Gomorrah was Lot and his family. He was told not to look back at Sodom while he fled, and his wife wanted to be a hardhead. She turned her ass and looked back, and she turned into a pillar of salt. So the only three people that was left out of Sodom and Gomorrah was Lot, who was the nephew of Abraham, and his two daughters. And they fled into the mountains. They fled into the mountains and hid in a cave. And they thought they was the only people left on the damn planet. So what they did is his daughters got him drunk. I guess when they was running up out of the fire and shit, that they saved a couple of bottles of yak. You know, I don't know where the fuck they got the wine from. But they when they got up in the cave, they drunk and shit and got him drunk. And they slept with their own goddamn father. And so out of that ancestral relationship came Moab and the other son, which was Ammon. That's why I don't like using them goddamn terms from ancient Egypt, because all of that shit is plagiarized from these wicked ass crackers. So the Moabites are the children of Lot and his daughter through an ancestral relationship. So why the hell would you say you was Moabites? Why would you even say some silly ass shit? Even the Canaanites were cursed by God in the Bible. So two of the motherfuckers you claim you are is cursed. And then I go back to Madame Blavatsky with her racist ass and the Aryans. And then I go back to Hitler, who adopted the Aryanism. And then I go back to the Hindus, who adopted the Aryanism, created the caste system. And I see, nigga, you tricking our goddamn peoples to accept themselves as a curse. Ain't no other fucking way to get around that. Niggas ought to skin you niggas. Niggas ought to take it to you niggas. Niggas need to be knocking y'all motherfucking ass out on the spot. Ain't no nigga, let's talk about it. Fuck, let's talk about it. You is busted, nigga. If a nigga had a wire on him and a niggas was in the street with that work, and we up in here with that work, got our bread and all of this shit laid out, and you in here talking good talk, nigga, and we hear a voice just start talking, like, what the fuck, where that voice come from, nigga? And niggas pull your motherfucking jacket open, nigga, you got a wire on you, nigga, you supposed to get dead, nigga. You in here snitching for the goddamn peoples, nigga, and this is what happened, nigga. I'm just using a street situation to explain what these niggas have done. These niggas been trying to snitch on us and co-opt us and get us to walk onto this ship thinking we gonna get gold, thinking we gonna get treasure, thinking we gonna get riches, and all we gonna get is some goddamn shackles on our neck, on our wrists, and on our goddamn ankles. And so we didn't pull the wire, and we didn't pull these niggas' Turkish hats off and all this goddamn Hindu shit off his back, and see these niggas got wires on. And these niggas been letting the beasts hear what we've been doing all along, tricking us. And so we got to deal with these niggas. Here we go, Lord Rama. And so you see this sister over there, no disrespect to the sister, because I don't believe she knew. I believe she following behind that silly nigga, probably respecting. He probably got the gift of gab. Noble Drew Ali got the gift of gab. So many of these sisters fall for these niggas. You know, they give a little here, a little there, and she believed the nigga telling the truth, followed the nigga, and then she end up accepting it, lock, stock, and barrel. And then 100 years later, here come a nigga named General Cyrus Susetti telling her and her goddamn daughters and her goddamn granddaughter that she been lied to. And because you done passed it down through the generations and you believe it so, it's hard for you to accept. Because y'all done put generational energy off into this shit. Okay? And so right there you see the number books. Foo Foo's Dream Book. Gypsy Fortune Teller. This shit was from back in the early 1900s. Letting you know that not only was it popular with Noble Drew Ali, it was popular amongst the communities as a whole, especially the number playing community. Everybody played the number, so everybody was getting these dream books and they seen this shit. So you cannot play no goddamn game. Look at the Hindu laugh. Talk, you know, this nigga think he me. Look at the goddamn Hindu laughing at this nigga. A fake ass nigga trying to play like he a Hindu. Nigga, you as a, in the caste system, nigga, you's a fucking outcast. These niggas got on Roger and goddamn Brahmin outfits, but in the caste system, nigga, you are outcast. Now look at the Fez. This is the Fez up out of Turkey. This is the, and then to the right, that's Rama, a Hindu deity. To show you that the Fez is from over in the Mongolian, upper north India region and have been over there for thousands of years. So Islam co-opted the Fez. They co-opted the Fez because many of the people out of that region end up becoming the dominant powers in the Islamic faith. But the Fez itself has nothing to do with Islam as a whole, as an origin, okay? It was a part of a whole different culture before Islam even existed. Again, looking at the Fez, then you're looking at the deity Rama over in India, okay? So it came from East Asia to Middle Asia, West Asia. And then from there, once the Ottoman Turk conquered most of the Mediterranean, Egypt up into the Sudan, all of Arabia, including Mecca, then the Fez became predominant